In this video, I'm going to share with you Kanye West's top success secrets that aren't shared anywhere else. Again, welcome to my channel. I'm Nicholas Bayerle. I was 60 pounds overweight, completely broke in business for multiple years, and didn't have a relationship for 7 years. And since then, we've turned it all around. I obviously lost the weight. I married my beautiful wife with a child on the way. And on top of that, our business has now been featured in Forbes, Entrepreneur. We've written a best-selling book called Modern Day Businessman and created a seven-figure business now impacting lives. So if you enjoy things like that and topics like business, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and subscribe to my channel. But getting into this actual video, we're going to be talking about Kanye West's success secrets. Now, I've only been following him for a little while now. Of course, I've listened to his music, yet I've been seeing a trend of how he's been able to actually go out there and go against the grain and create massive amount of buzz and a massive amount of success, and how you can take the things that he's doing right now in his life and apply it to your life by the end of this video. So you're gonna wanna stay to the very end to get all the success tips so you can use it for yourself to create more success in your life, financially, freedom-wise, and impact-wise, the same way that he's doing it. So let's get into it. So the first thing that's absolutely undeniable with what Kanye West is doing right now is his confidence, the way that he's speaking his message. There's actually a quote out there that says, if you speak something enough times with enough confidence, it'll soon become truth. That when you speak something with the confidence needed, and enough times, people just assume that it's great. Like when you say, I'm the best. I'm the very best at what I do. I'm the best rapper in the world. I'm the best musician. I'm the best artist in the world. When you speak with enough confidence enough times, all of a sudden we start seeing like, man, this guy must be actually truthful about this. Like this must actually be fact figures. He even said in one of his interviews that inside of schools right now, of anyone or anything in the world, he is the most popular with kids inside of schools. And he said it with such confidence that I just assumed this must be true. He says he's the best artist on the planet to have ever lived. And I just started telling my friends, I'm like, man, Kanye West is on a roll. He's the most known guy, even though he has no Instagram with all the kids, even though he's not on any of the platforms. On top of that, his shoe company is the number one searched designer brand on the planet. And he's the best rapper, performer, and artist to ever live. And I just started telling this, and all of a sudden now I could see how these things can go viral because he has so much confidence in the things that he's been doing now, but also you can see over his career in the past, since I've been looking at his other videos, he's consistently known where he's going and spoke that message with confidence, almost to the point where that reality was almost created by the confidence that he had. So think about for you, how can you speak your message with confidence? And even if you like, you go look at his videos, like his music videos don't have as many views. And like, again, this isn't about whether he is or isn't. This is about the fact that people could argue that he's not, but he doesn't allow that to stop him. He speaks his message with confidence enough times until it becomes truth in all of our eyes. And we say he's the best artist. We say he's the best rapper. We go out there and say he has influence over everyone else and that his shoe brand's number one. The second thing that most people are missing out on is he's also been transparent. If you notice, there's been a lot of things that Kanye has done in his life that would not be things that he would love to share in front of people. He would like to push under the rug. And for a lot of people, they'd be things that would disqualify them from their success. Like when he went to the hospital because they figured out that he had a mental condition. Now, whether he does or doesn't, again, doesn't matter. But what does matter is a lot of times we have things in our lives that have happened to us, like when I was overweight. When I was overweight, I was scared to share my before photos. I was scared to put myself out there because I was scared to get judged by everyone else. So I tried to hide all those things. Yet Kanye lives a life that he cannot hide anything from anyone. Everything's out there, everything's transparent. He even talked about the last time that he got to go into public. He remembers He remembers actually going to a shopping center, a mall, and he was going to a record place and he was going to shop. And he remembers like right before he was about to hit, like right before he's about to become famous, he was like, this is the last time I'm ever going to be able to go out into public alone. Like never again is this going to happen. So I'm going to cherish this moment. His life has been blasted out. And a lot of times that can be super difficult. But what I've seen him do is I've seen him own his failures, speak about his failures, talk about how he was addicted to porn and how he got a Playboy magazine when he was 5 years old and how that shaped his life. Why is that important? Because in success, more people can actually identify with your failures than your successes. Not everyone has the number one designer brand, the top search term on Google, the most whatever these things are, these accolades. They're great things because they give you the accolades on why you're good at what you do, yet more people can actually connect with your failures than they can with your actual successes. On top of that, that gives Kanye a bunch of fuel because he's not hiding who he is. You look at 8 Mile with Eminem, and at the very end, he was like, screw it. I'm gonna go up there, I'm gonna tell everyone what's happened to me, what's wrong with me, I am white, I am a bum, I do live in a trailer with my mom. He said everything, and it gave him power because now he wasn't hiding who he was. He had accepted it, he had put it out there, and people had no ammunition to use against him. Kanye is doing the same thing, so can you. Number three is Kanye has gone against the grain. He always talks about how he's come up with these new trends. He started like doing things with skinny jeans. He started doing things with high fashion. He started shifting his voice, and people kept saying like, I like the old Kanye, but he would never get stuck in what he wanted other people, what other people wanted him to be. He would always go after what he wanted to be. And he describes it like this. He says that if you go to an Apple store and you want an iPhone 4, you're not going to find it in the Apple store because iPhones have gone on and graduated and changed over the years. If you want to grab it, you can go back in time. Even when people ask him, Kanye, are you going to sing your old music? It's like, listen, if you want my old music, go grab it somewhere else. Like you would grab an iPhone on eBay. You can go on YouTube, you can go online, you can find his old music. But he has transformed as a person. And so many times for us, I feel like most people out there, they end up going and shifting who they are based on who people want them to be. And this happens to influencers all over the place. They blow up one time and then they never change their identity from that person, and it drives them insane. So he's gone against the grain creatively, and he's put himself out there time after time. Now, if you want to use this to your advantage, look at cutting edge things that are happening. See, it's one thing to have a new idea, but a lot of times that's like coming to America, right? The first person to discover something is always the person that gets the arrows in the back. That's what happens to Kanye. He's the first person to discover things. Yet after that, before it becomes trendy, before it becomes mainstream, you can jump on it before other people do, and it'll help you have greater success. And number four is he has owned his voice. He has actually gone out there and spoken what he believes, not based on how he wants people to respond, but he's speaking what he believes with that confidence and not being scared. He talked about when he first came on the scene about 10 years ago or so, that he would love to be a Christian rapper, but his songs would never get played if they were about Jesus. And so what did he do? He went out there and he sang about Jesus and they got played. And he went out there and he said these things over and over again. People have said that he's ruined his career. People have said that he's totally screwed up his entire life. And people have even said with him releasing his new album, Jesus is King, that it wouldn't get played, that this would ruin his career. And all we've seen is videos like this coming out and you searching videos like this because you're interested in what Kanye is doing. He's not on Instagram, so he's using that to his advantage. And he's going out there and speaking his own voice, what he believes, because he knows that a certain amount of people will connect with it. People thought his career was over when he supported Trump and he was wearing the red hat, but he knew that if he continually spoke what he believed with confidence, then soon a certain amount of people will connect with that person, and he wasn't afraid of the outcome. For him, he would say he's more afraid of fulfilling the will of God on the earth than he is of people's judgments. To wrap up these points, point number one is his confidence, speaking his message with confidence until it becomes truth in other people's eyes. If you speak it over and over again, your message can become truth. He says he's the best. He says that he's the best that ever lived. He said that he's number one. And because of that, we all believe he's number one because we just assume, man, he's so confident in it. Number two, he's transparent in his messaging. He's transparent with where he's going. He's transparent with where he's at. And he's transparent with his past, which makes us feel like we can connect with him, and it gives him freedom to speak his message because he knows nothing's going to come out against him that hasn't been shared by him directly. The third thing is he has gone against the grain. He hasn't gotten stuck in who Kanye was. He hasn't gotten stuck with what he believes and try to make other people happy. He's gone out there and done things differently, from skinny jeans to new ways of rapping to going out there and producing what people would call a gospel album that's rap. And he's gone out there and done it anyway, and he's seen the successes of continually following his creative passion. The last thing, number four, is owning your own voice, taking a stand for what you believe in. He wanted to be a Christian rapper, and he didn't believe it was even possible. He wasn't even sure if he could do it, and he went out there and he did it anyway. And because he's consistently owned his voice, not shifted based on people's opinions, Kanye has been able to go out there and crush it year after year, and now attributes his success to God, that he was making hundreds of millions of dollars and wasn't really becoming profitable, to now getting a $68 million tax refund from the IRS. And Kanye has gone out there and built brands and become number one in different industries, and he continues to do so. So if you want to be like Kanye, just like I do, we together, we're gonna wanna take action and be successful like Kanye and take these four success secrets that you can implement in your life and take action on them right now. Again, if you love this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit the thumbs up, and go leave us a comment below. And I appreciate you, good connecting, and can't wait to see you on the next video.